Hi, I'm Steven from Charter Medical. You may have made an appointment to get a body composition scan, like on the devices that we make behind me. And you might be wondering, is there anything I need to do before my scan to make sure my results are best? You know, so for example, before doing some medical examinations, they might tell you, you know, don't eat for 24 hours or don't drink anything before it and stuff like that. So we're here to answer some questions you may have about how to get the best results. And by the best results, I don't mean, you know, how do I get the lowest body fat? How do I trick the machine into telling me I have a lower body fat? The purpose of these kind of scans, obviously, isn't to make you feel good. It's to make sure you have the best and most accurate results, so you know where you are and, you know, what you can do to improve. By using a body composition analyzer, you can get a better understanding of your body's body fat, your muscle, your water, or even cellular health. So BIA devices were originally used in more medical settings. In fact, all of Charter's body composition analyzers are medically certified. We have Class 2 European Union certification. But nowadays, a lot of fitness centers or sports training centers will also use our devices. And you can use them as a good way to track your change. So normally, in the past, you might have gone to a hospital, let's say, you know, once every half a year, just to get, you know, the doctor will tell you how much fat you have and something like that. And that's important, of course. But at your fitness center, you might want to be doing a scan, you know, once every month to see if you've been burning fat or if you've been, you know, growing muscle through your training. So our devices are designed to be easy to operate. It's really easy to conduct a measurement. But even so, there are some things that you should be aware of before measuring to make sure that you get the most accurate results. So we've tested the effect of some different BIA-related recommendations. So for example, the standard list of recommendations will include stuff like don't drink coffee before measurement because coffee is a diuretic and it might, you know, cause some form of dehydration. Or don't take a shower immediately before measurement because that might affect the body temperature of the skin, which might affect results. In our experience, some things matter and some things don't really matter as much. Now, obviously, if possible, you want to do everything by the book to make sure you have the best results. But in reality, realistically speaking, some things just don't matter as much. And so today, I'm going to be sharing about three of the major things that will make the biggest difference in accuracy for your results. Number one, the big factor is that we see in a lot of fitness centers is that they'll have someone scan after exercising. Now, that's not really good because after a vigorous workout, you know, your body is oftentimes sweating or else you're doing something wrong. So it's oftentimes sweating and your blood circulation has increased. Now, this is a problem for BIA devices because they utilize electrical impedance that goes through your body. And impedance is affected a lot by body water. Now, if you're sweating and you just drank something and your blood is going, your body is basically not in a normal state. And so the results really aren't what they should be in terms of reality. So maybe you measure after exercising, right? And your body fat measurement says, you know, 14%. And you're like, all right, 14%. But maybe, you know, 2 hours later, you do another measurement and then it says 16%. And you're like, well, what's going on? Why is it 16%? What's the actual truth? And in reality, 16% is closer to the actual reality of your measurements. So that's just the one thing to remember. Measure before exercising and not after. Number two, definitely make sure that you go to the bathroom before measurement. You know, so the reason for this is because these BIA scanners, in addition to using electrical impedance and stuff like your height, your age, and stuff like that, in a key measurement that they use is body weight. Now, you know, as stuff turns into waste matter, it's not really part of your body composition. Yes, it's still in your body, but it's not actually part of your body. You're going to be getting rid of it very soon. So by going to the bathroom before measurement, you can ensure that the scanner only scans all of what's actually you, and not something that's going to be gone in a few moments. Number three, and probably most important, is that you don't want to be eating or drinking right before conducting a measurement. Now, the reason for this is similar to what I was saying before, how body weight can affect the accuracy of your results. So, for example, let's say you drank 1 liter of water right before conducting a measurement. What's going to happen? In our testing, what we found is this. Your impedance doesn't change that much because water and anything else takes time to absorb and to become part of your body. If you drink a liter of water, it's not going to result, you know, have an increase of 1 liter in your body water. That's not how it works, you know. As it goes through your system, it needs to be absorbed and digested. And in fact, if you drink too much all at once, it's just going to go, you know, straight out as pee, right? So if you drink a liter of water and maybe you're going to see the results of your machine say that your body fat increased because your impedance overall hasn't changed like it might be if you had gotten 1 kilogram heavier due to an increase in muscle. Now, what's really interesting is when it comes to food, because that's actually slightly different from water, even though you shouldn't be eating or drinking right before measurement for the same reason. So after you eat something, let's say you ate 500 grams, you know, of food, you had a sandwich or something like that. I guess that's a pretty big sandwich. So you're going to see something similar, which is that your body fat reading might increase a little bit after eating and measuring, because again, your weight has increased, but your impedance has remained roughly the same. But the really interesting thing is that over the course of an hour or so, as your body digests the food, you might see your body fat actually fluctuate and even increase further. Now the reason for this is that during the process of digestion, your body might be bringing in blood and water from other parts of the body into your digestive system to help digest the food. Now that's going to affect the impedance and other measurements of the rest of your body, and that can affect the accuracy of the results. Now after, you know, 2 hours or so, or however long it takes for you to digest your food, you should start seeing your results return back to normal. So that's why you might be seeing a higher body fat result after eating or drinking something. It's not because the machine is broken, that's just how the technology works, and we have to understand how these machines work to get the best and most accurate results. So to recap, there are 3 things you need to do to make sure that your results are as accurate as possible. So number 1, have your scan before exercising and not after. Number 2, make sure you go to the bathroom before conducting your scan to make sure you get rid of any extra weight. And number 3, make sure that you have at least given yourself maybe 1 or 2 hours after you've eaten or drinking anything to conduct your scan. I hope that helped. And as always, feel free to contact us if you have any questions. Thank you.